It's been said that your grandfather brought dead tissue back to life. Is that true, Dr. Frankenstein? It's been said that your grandfather created a horrifying monster. Is that true, Dr. Frankenstein? It's been said, nay, even sung, that your grandfather's monster hurt and lamed, killed and maimed. Is that true, Dr. Frankenstein?
Is that true, Dr. Frankenstein? Is that true, Dr. Frankenstein? Is that true? Is that true? Is that true? Is that true? Is that true, Dr. Frankenstein?
That's Frankenstein. My name. It's pronounced Frankenstein. Yes. The whole world knows what my grandfather did. But please, do I look like the kind of madman who'd prowl around graveyards digging up freshly buried corpses?
Well, Professor...
Don't answer that. I'm not a Frankenstein. I don't indulge in hijinks or tomfoolery. I'm not a Frankenstein. I don't believe in mummies, ghosts, or ghoulery. I deal in fact, not fiction. I am a scientist. I live for truth and reason. That's the reason I exist. There is a vast difference between my crazy grandfather's delusional experiments and my own devotion to pure science, which leads us directly to the subject of today's lecture. The brain. There is nothing like the brain. Hearts and lungs are simply tinker toys when stacked against the brain. Insane, I'm insane about the brain. No invention in the universe is equal to the brain. The mouth's a marvel when it comes to eating. I've nothing against the womb. I thank the bladder when I'm excreting, and I always give the elbow room. But the brain, please allow me to explain. There's no organ can compare to it. I swear to it, it's plain. It's the brain. Mr. Hilltop here, with whom I have never worked nor given any prior instruction to, has graciously offered his services for this afternoon's demonstration. His medulla oblongata tells his brainstem that it's gotta send an impulse full of data, which creates a lot of pain. His frontal lobe gets busy with a thought that makes him dizzy, puts his cortex in a tizzy, so he never will complain. That's what I love about the brain. Mr. Hilltop, will you raise your left knee, please? You have just witnessed a voluntary nerve impulse. Mr. Hilltop, you may lower your knee. Reflex movements, on the other hand, are those which are made independently of the will. Why, you dirty, rotten, yellow son of a bitch!
Oh!
Even though I almost need him, his reflexes have no freedom to react. When I mistreat him, it's important I explain. Synaptic nerve connection goes its way without detection, bringing cranial protection in a never-ending chain. That's what I love about the brain. But what if we were to block those nerve impulses by simply applying local pressure? Which can be done with any ordinary metal clamp, just at the swelling at the posterior nerve roots for, say, 4 seconds. Why, you mother-grabbing bastard! As you can see, even though I have just smashed my knee into his crotch, he does not react. He feels absolutely nothing. More or less. So, if it were not for this continuous stream of motor impulses from the brain, we would collapse like a bunch of broccoli! And in conclusion, so there's no confusion, let me say it once again. Though your genitalia has been known to fail you, you can bet your ass on the brain! Everybody! Copernicus, Kepler, and Newton. Compare me to Freud and I feel highfalutin. Call me a Darwin, I love that man's theory. Call me Pasteur and watch me get teary. Say Madame Curie, that would be the best. Call me a Rorschach, come up to the test. I really light up when you call me Edison. Call me an Ehrlich, I like that man's medicine. Call me Marconi, that wireless wow. Call me Popoff and I bark like a chow. Woof. Call me an Einstein and that would be fine. Call me a Tesla, I wouldn't decline. To call me a Frankenstein would be insane. Cause I love